My hell of a mixture, even though it's fucked up. Girl, I'm still fucking with you, damn. Is it the fall? Time for me to revisit the past. The women, the cars, the doctors, the drivers, liquor involved, the stories to tell, we've been through it all. Interviews are like confessions. Get the fuck about my dressing room, confusing me with questions like, do you love this shit? Are you high right now? Do you ever get nervous? Are you single? I heard you fuck your girl, is it true? You getting money? You think the niggas you with is with you? And I say, hell yeah, hell yeah.
Chronicles. I am Miss Mindy Jones, and beside me is my bestie and business partner, Miss Coley Rodriguez. What's good, mamas?
Hey, what's good? As you said, you are tuned into PGC. I'm Coley Rodriguez, and we are here at Cole's Event Center, 2928 West Kentucky Street. And in between us tonight, we have another podcast in the building. This is, like, we love this, because normally we have just, like, you know, artists, entrepreneurs, DJs, you know, actors, actresses, models, you know, to have another podcast on. I think we've only other had on was Balls and Beats.
Right.
The Balls and Beats podcast. So in between me and Mindy, I got Pete right here, right?
Yes.
And then got Q beside him, beside Mindy. And what is the name of y'all's podcast? Why don't you tell her?
Beyond the Game podcast.
Yes. I just wanted y'all to say it because, you know, when somebody introduced their own show, they kind of say it a little bit different. You know, I just wanted to hear, you know, that's right.
Is that how y'all say it?
Yeah, Beyond the Game.
BTG. Shorten it up a little bit.
BTG.
BGC. And we thank y'all ladies for inviting us down here tonight.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah, we appreciate it. Real quick, if you're watching this video, share this video with your friends, tag them, like the Pretty Girl Chronicles page. Like their page, because you guys have a page too, right?
Yeah, for sure. Make sure you like that as well. Beyond the Game, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Tumblr, whatever social media is out there.
So hopefully y'all shared that real quick if you're watching this. We'll tell you to share it again in a minute. But anyway, why don't you tell them a little bit about your podcast and what goes on there? What will y'all talk about?
Okay, let me get comfortable.
Yeah, get comfortable because we're ready to hear for a little bit. Yeah. So go ahead and get comfortable.
So anyways, Beyond the Game is a radio sports show. We talk about, you know, pretty much basically your barbershop talk, your water cooler talk, things that, you know, you talk about when you go to work that next day. Did you see this? Did you see that? And also, the reason why it's named Beyond the Game is because we don't just talk about sports. We talk about things that's going on in society, race issues and things of that nature. Things that most sports shows are scared to address because of for whatever reason, but with us, we dive on into it.
Yeah, maybe some sponsorship issues or something that
we're
afraid of.
Yeah.
Or
whatever.
We talk about it all.
We just tell the real, you know. What they want to say is what we say.
Pretty much.
You know, what people can't say when they on ESPN and all the other sports podcasts and radio shows.
Bring it real.
There's no filter about sports and the issues that we're facing today in society, basically, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay. And I like that. From some educated men giving their point of view, because you know, you don't always get that. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like, you know, we might get a lot of women saying their opinions or whatever, but to have, like, educated men actually voicing their opinions, I mean, that's dope to me.
Right.
Okay, so, moving forward.
So when did you guys, like individually or collectively, realize this, like doing your podcast, this is what you wanted to do? I take it that you're trying to take it beyond where it is right now, correct?
Yeah, we would definitely like to, you know, make it grow, bring it to a bigger platform as far as radio is concerned. But actually, it got started by accident, really. You know, Pete, I've been knowing him for over 25 years.
Yeah, they're like besties.
Actually, this started with me and my dude Kyle Keezy. Shout out to Keezy, he's in Florida right now. And you know how people have group text messages. We would always argue in group text messages. Well, To make a long story short, this guy had a gospel radio station. And he's like, man, you know a lot about sports. Do you mind coming on? Because gospel people, Christians, we want to know what's going on with sports too. He's like, do you mind coming on doing a segment? So I was like, sure, no problem. So I came on there, did like a little 15-minute segment. And then afterwards, he was like, man, you got a talent for this. You're real natural with this. You ever thought about doing something? And I was like, nah, man, I just did this because you asked me to come on. So for like a week straight, he was only asking me every single day. And finally, I was like, yeah, just set it up. So he set it up.
I'll do it.
I was like, man, you go keep bothering me, back, man. So he set it up with the assistant program director at the radio station. So we emailed back and forth, you know, to set up a time for an interview. I came in, I told her my thoughts, what I was trying to do, and she said, well, we got one slot left at that time. It was on Tuesdays from 11:30. If you want it, it's yours. And so I ended up falling into something that I never even had a bad, like, I never even thought I would ever be on the radio, and I just lucked up into it. And it just so happens that Kyle, the guy I was doing it with, he moved to Florida with his wife. That's where Pete B come into the equation. So I've been knowing Pete for 25 plus years. I know B because we work together, and it just all came full circle. And now we on the show every Monday night from 6 to 7 on 93.9 FM. And, you know, I educate these guys on sports and everything.
That's what's up.
He just tells us his opinion. He don't educate.
Right, he's like, I'm already educated on sports. That's why I'm on the show.
No,
look.
I know, I may not be right, but I ain't never wrong.
I bring the controversy, you know, I just tell him what it is.
You don't say.
And how it should be. That's
okay, you the spicy one.
Yeah,
it's
just, yeah.
Okay, cute.
We
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's the troublemaker.
He the troublemaker.
Yeah,
he right.
He
gets
under
everybody's
skin.
Right.
And
so
thing,
you
right.
Like the Charlemagne.
Right.
That's who he is. He's our Charlemagne.
Shots fired.
That's who he is, and we can't have people, like, people in Lexington can't wait to get on the show, not to talk about sports,
but so argue talk with him, right? Exactly. They be like, I've been waiting to shut him up, I've been holding this point for three, now look.
You're right, there can be people who like having things they want to say to him for like weeks and months at a time. And they're like, man, can we get on? I'm like, man, you gotta get in line with the rest of them.
Right,
man.
And I'll schedule you in.
I tell them their opinions don't even matter. I mean, it is what it is.
And he is like, Pete is a natural at knowing what
buttons
to push.
Pete
see,
is just cocky.
He knows what buttons
right.
To push
he only
to get
under
people's
finished.
Nerves. That's what he does. That's what he does.
It does. You gotta have that little spice, you know, that spice to it or whatever. So if you guys could have any guests on your show right now, PGC could wave a magic wand and we could bring them here. Who would it be? Mm. Who would be your favorite? Yes. Like.
Who?
Like,
I already know who
you're
gonna say. I got a feeling.
Who? What
he
got?
LeBron.
I thought he was gonna say LeBron.
LeBron. Yeah. Yo, he was like, I already knew he was gonna say LeBron.
Hands down, man. Brian, reach out to us, man. Come on, BTG, holler at your boy, man. You know what it is.
Anybody tag LeBron if you know.
Tag LeBron. Tag his business partners. Tag anybody that you know that's associated with LeBron somehow, some way. Get him on the show.
Cousin, you know somebody who used to mess with his cousin?
Right.
Anyway, get
his manicurist, okay.
Somebody,
you know,
barber.
So many said, black man don't cheat.
We don't.
At all, on any
so
level.
You can't reach out to anybody, man. You got to be in this circle. You got to know.
That's why I said the barber.
Yeah, the barber.
Right. But after you swing through there, just don't think you're already in the area.
We just bring them on down here. We all together.
Right. Teamwork makes the dream work.
That's what's up. Yes, sir. What about you, Kim?
For me, it's going to be Shannon Sharp.
Okay.
Yeah, I love Uncle Shannon, man.
Genuinely, look at that smile. I love Uncle Shannon, man.
He be dropping some knowledge.
I mean, he got everything you want. He got knowledge. He's funny, and he's a country dude, so like he's very relatable. So that's who I would add.
No, he is very relatable, and he is funny, and he's got a big smile and a, like I like him. Like I mean, he's a cool dude. I can see why you pick him. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. LeBron James
and Shannon Sharp.
Shannon Sharp.
Plus, you know, with Shannon, the ladies like looking at Shannon Sharp, so he gonna bring them in as well. Because
everybody know who he is.
As soon as they see him,
they're gonna be like, oh, shit.
Exactly. So that's gonna bring the female viewers. There we go. We got it.
Yeah,
already got it.
I'm sure, you know, when LeBron comes, he gonna bring plenty sure viewers of himself.
That's gonna be a short interview because he gonna fan out and pass. He's gonna fan out and pass out. So that's gonna be a short interview.
You gonna have to finish it, wake him back up. Like
interview done, bro. We good here.
Now we're going to sit down and have a real conversation about how he to go.
You know what? Definitely.
So y'all ladies watch sports? Y'all sports real heavy?
Yes.
Her, yes, me, not so much.
You not so much? Did you play sports? What about you? Did you play sports growing up?
Well, I guess people differ on what sports is, but I was a cheerleader and I was on every dance team or danced in front of the band because I went to a, you know, predominantly black high school. So, you know what I mean? Like, I was always in some activity where I had to perform and be at a practice.
Yes.
So.
Now, my daughter, she dances in cheer, so it's a sport.
Yeah, because it's hard work. Cheerleading is hard fucking work. Mm-hmm. Like, you have to hold your arm in these positions for a long time. Like, it's hard work.
You got to be damn near a gymnast to cheer.
Pete, you got a dance team?
Easy, cute.
did you really?
Yeah, like, he did.
No.
Yes, he did.
He
said,
no.
But I didn't really think he did because I was going to be like, was you really on the dance team?
He was.
I was not.
You'd be surprised.
I'd be in the middle of the club dancing if you call that a dance team.
Man, I was DJ was watching right now. I was going to say, DJ tagging my own Miss Lynn to put the pictures up, put the videos up of Pete dancing back in the day.
Look. Share this video if you're watching it. I just wanted to say that because I said it earlier, and I don't know if you was on there, but if you're on now, you need to share the video for us. Like the Pretty Girl Chronicles page, and make sure you like Beyond the Games page, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, everything y'all got. YouTube. I just want to listen.
Everything.
We're on
everything.
So real quick, you guys, what are y'all currently working on or looking forward to with Beyond the Games?
Well, actually, me and Pete was just talking about that on the way down here. Like, how can we continue to grow the show? Because what we don't want to do is get to a stagnant point where we're just comfortable and content with things. Like, yeah, we good now. So we wanted to sit down with us, with B, you know, whenever we start to feel better about what avenues, what different things we can do to start.
What's up next?
Exactly. Pretty much what's up next. What's the next phase in this? Do we just want to keep it where it's at? Or do we want to branch out and have, like, other reporters or other people go out in other different stations and things like that, but still be part of Beyond the Game to branch out to where it's just more than just us doing.
Yeah, like a team.
Yeah,
like a Beyond the Game team. Yeah.
So with us, we do mainly like NBA, NFL, all the major sports, but I would like for to branch out to the local things, but still be a part of underneath the Beyond the Game umbrella. You see what I'm saying? But have local, get local kids in there. And matter of fact, I wanted to discuss this with Pete. On the show, you know, when kids do their Santa days, have the kids do their Santa days from the show. So therefore, that brings their families into it and have other avenues of people watching for this kid to see where he's gonna sign to play baseball, football, hockey, whatever the case.
That's a hot one right there. Like, a lot of people watch those announcement days, yeah. I guess you will call it. A lot of people watch those trends, you know what I'm saying? Like, when somebody's announcement day, they like number one all around, all American, or whatever situation, you know what I mean? Whatever they coming from, because like, those should be trending. So if you can make that happen on your show, even, you know, people who are just coming to school around here, but then eventually you'll start getting the people that's not just from this area, you know, like they'll all, you know, it'll work out. That's a good idea. Y'all should definitely run with that.
It's like, no matter where that kid goes in life, nobody can take that moment and the experience away from him, because for the rest of your life, man, I made my signing day experience on the radio. Like, that's with him, that's public knowledge that he can always go back and refer to that no matter where he's at in life. So I think it'll be a dope experience, not just for him, but his family as well.
Oh, I do too, yeah, it's a good idea.
To touch on the black aspect of it, it's like, man, these black guys on the radio, and they want us to, because black people don't have enough avenues to get that information out. So when you have a kid who's doing something, it doesn't really get broadcast a lot because on news stations, they're not really worried about that too much for real. So when you have these local kids going to, whether it's a small college or a major college, they don't have no way to get that information out to people to let them know this is where I'm going to in case you want to follow my career. So with us, it'd be a win-win situation. You come on, announce it with us, you know, at the same time you bring new viewers to us and we get your message out at the same time.
Yeah, no, I think that's a good idea. But, like, that's why we are here doing PGC, because not enough people of color, you know, have an avenue to perform. Yeah. We get a lot of performers that this is the only place they ever performed or their first time performing.
Right.
You know, so that, like, that's why we do it. Like, we want to show what we got, you know. So if anybody's watching the video at that time, I don't know who could be watching, they might love you. You know what I mean? Like, I'm trying to put you on, you know? Yeah. Like, basically, that's what we're doing. We're like, we're trying to put you on. You need to come, so.
Exactly.
And then sometimes people will never have a way to record themselves performing at all, and they never see themselves on tape, and it's a way for them to go back and refer to the tape and watch the performance, critique it, you know? Like, I mean, there's a lot of benefits from performing on the show.
Nah, don't
go
down. Nah, it's good.
Yeah.
I got a question for y'all. How long y'all been doing this? How long y'all been doing Pretty Girl Chronicles?
March will be 2 years.
Yeah. 2 years. So how did y'all get started?
Well,
Whose idea was it?
Oh, actually,
it kind of got dropped in our laps. Like, she's hosted a lot of things for a long time, and so have I. And she had already had the idea of doing a podcast. It just hadn't come to fruition yet. So we got the opportunity to create this, and we it's fallen into what it is today, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, but she couldn't have said it better. That's pretty, you know what I mean? Like, we both hosted shit for a long time. I love radio, you know what I'm saying? She loves hosting radio too, you know? Like, we got the opportunity, we was like, and we were both just, you know how, like, you guys, you feel like it's what you're supposed to do. So when you do it, it's not a struggle, it's not an issue, you know? You're not contemplating how this is gonna happen, it just happens, you know? And when you feel like that at your job, that's how you know that's what you're meant to do. And that's how we kind of feel, you know? Like, it's what we're meant to do, like how you guys are, that's what, you know, like, not an issue. It's, you know, like, we just love it, yeah. So we're happy to do it. Like, we're not like, oh my god, I gotta be on camera or talk, you know? We're like, oh my god, yes.
It's not like, oh my gosh, we gotta do a show today.
Yeah, you know, yeah. We're like, yes, you know what I'm saying? Like, we're about to fuck it up again, you know? Like,
yeah,
oh shit, my bad.
Hey, you gotta be yourself. Yeah,
you gotta be yourself.
Oh, we good? Okay.
Yeah, fuck that shit. Hey, yo, fuck that shit, homes, okay? Yo, fuck that shit. Shout out. Who tuned into the video real quick, maybe? Because I know you got it up on there.
So right now we got tuned in. It's Chris DJ Day Day. Okay. DeAndre. Oh, is that you?
Yeah, that's
you. Look, he was in the video. He had tuned in for a minute. Watching himself. Like, well, I look like, okay, well, I look good.
Kynes is tuned in. Amy from the sports beat. Key, she's tuned in. Bappy Bishop, shout out to you for tuning in. And all the others who tuned in earlier.
Yeah, like, she ain't got to read more. We just going to do a couple, you know, here and there, because we appreciate y'all tuning in. You know, that's love. Like, it's hard to do this shit. It's hard to do this shit, you know? Okay. So, what are your pet peeves? Like, shit you just don't jig with?
In general, with women?
General, personal, business. You can name all three. Like, whatever you just don't fuck with.
Mine is negativity. I don't deal with negativity at all. No salt being thrown, none of that. You know, I just want to uplift everybody, always positive. Okay. You know, you catch me, I don't care what's going on. I'm going to look at the positive side of it.
My dude always got a smile on his face.
Always. Ain't no reason to frown. You only got one life, you might as well live it. Take the good with the bad, keep it moving.
Yo, man, mine's ain't as uplifting as positive and black movement as his is. Mine's
not uplifting and positive and black movement.
Mine's ain't all
that was the funniest shit.
Shit, really, man? I don't know. For real, I mean, something simple like work related. Don't talk to me first thing in the morning.
Don't you hate that shit? Why do people schedule meetings at 8 a.m.? I hate those types of people.
Yeah, like, I just got in here. Sometimes I just got the cold out my eyes, man. Let me get adjusted. Can I get breakfast? Can I get some milk? Like, can I chill for a second?
Can I get some milk? Can I get some milk in my cereal?
Hey, how you doing? Good morning. How's your morning? Like, dang. Like, let me chill for a second. They want to talk to you about last so night, funny. Work yesterday, and all that. I'm like, bro, I ain't doing all
don't
that.
Don't come shoving work down my face. Yeah, I just got there. I hate that.
That is the worst thing, to clock in and somebody's just right there in your face ready to go already.
Oh, no.
Yeah,
they probably haven't been there since like 6. They already had their 1-2 cups, you know, I'm sorry you didn't shuffle in this motherfucker to 8:45, but I don't need you to give me that shit.
I was like, you lucky I barely came in today, let alone talking to you today.
I'm saying shit every day at work. Y'all lucky I'm in this motherfucker. Right. Don't ask me shit.
Look, I got PTO days out this bitch. Like, okay.
No, act like I won't leave early today. You talking to me.
Right.
Leave you here by yourself.
I use my damn one personal holiday, and I got two of them bitches left. I will be here early. Y'all
still. So what would be you guys' okay, so this is us getting to know you a little bit more personally.
What personally?
What would be your ideal thing? Like, you could have taken shit on a date. In any budget, not like what your points look like now. Like,
right. Whatever, okay. Whatever you could do.
Okay. My budget right now is a real formal boy.
He was like, right now we're ready to formal boy.
Real formal boyish over here.
That
Boba Fo
is
incredibly filling
though.
Don't hey,
don't
hate Boba Fo.
Because
I get
that
crispy chicken BLT
and
that
motherfucker
can be
right
though.
Yeah, I don't know. Like y'all too
good
for that
Boba Fo.
That's like a chicken go wrap every time I'm on my chicken.
I'm doing
everything, yes. With lemonade,
I
got
the
crispy chicken BLT.
Oh,
on
lunchtime? Hey, Peter?
I'm
a simple guy, you know. So first off, go grab something to eat. You know, big fella likes to eat. We're gonna sit in there and have a good conversation.
That's the start of a good date when you get some really good food.
Absolutely.
Because you know what?
They good can make food, a break a date.
Yes, because good food sets off those like happy endorphins in your body. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So if you like, oh yeah, that's a good date.
This nigga beat me? Yes.
And I don't mean like regular, like a poor before. I mean like,
factual. If you keep her hungry, she is gonna hate you
for the whole night.
She's gonna be hungry too.
You need to do that first.
So then after that, we'll probably go to a little spot, listen to some music or some hopefully live band or somebody playing. You know, get to know each other a little bit better there. And then after that, take her home.
And kiss her on her forehead.
Nah, we don't do it. Not on the first day. I don't do it on the first day. Man, I got
kids. See, I said and kiss on the forehead.
Well, nah, I don't do no fash.
No, that'll make somebody crazy.
That forehead kiss will get you on the living room couch.
I've
been there before.
Forehead kiss will get you in the door. You know what? I got a couple extra months. Come on here for a second.
Hey, especially if you like grab the sides of the like head.
Push
your hair back.
Yeah.
If they bring the head to you.
That hair back, I'll be good night and kiss on the voice.
Man,
like, you know what? I gotta go to work till 10 o'clock. You wanna come in for a little bit?
Tell you just come on in, just start putting your clothes in the drawer.
Right,
just
start.
That fast.
Oh, man.
That
got a toothbrush. I had a suspicion.
Right.
Now, but you gotta look at that.
Like, I just knew it was gonna work out with you.
I've been in the spot. I've been with a chick before. She was like, yeah, just get a toothbrush under the sink. And I went up on there, she had like a six pack. But I'm gonna get me one though.
That's a nice toothbrush, but I'm gonna go ahead and
get it. That's actually quite conservative. If she's gonna do it, she's thinking about you.
She's a conservative woman.
It's like whoever I fuck with in the future, whatever, go have fresh breath.
What you're not gonna do is have winter breath.
If she had deodorant, shave cream, and razors, we got an issue.
If she got a whole starter kit for you, like, okay, this is a new boyfriend starter kit. Like, here's what she give you.
Just grab one of them bags. Just grab one of them bags up under the sink.
It's a toothbrush, deodorant, soap, like a razor, shave cream, little aftershave. You good.
I'm
like,
not leaving that here. Can I tell you? You ain't gonna remember to bring it back.
Right, leave that here.
Bring
look, there's a Sharpie underneath it.
Write the name on it.
Write the name on it, boo.
Check it in and out.
And then you start looking and you see like Jeff. And then you see like Scott or whatever.
You gonna fuck around to your niggas.
Like Cuban hair.
Right. Because it's gonna be all like Quentin Walker, BDS, or whatever, you know, like your real shit. Like, because you roll it all the way out. Like, no. Because you'd be like, he writes his shit out like that. Like, you would know, because you his friend, you'd be like, it's not like, wow, that was really funny. Okay. What's in your playlist? Like, if you're about to go out, you at the crib chilling, like, what's some of your favorite artists that you like to play?
PNB Rock right now, Daniel Caesar.
Daniel Caesar, yes.
I rock with those, you know, for the mellow mood. You know, then I, of course you gotta have your Future in there. You don't?
Oh, I'm with you.
Yeah.
No, you don't.
Future.
Well, yeah, you do. You gotta have Future.
Oh, Future, this new Future shit. This dope team Future, no, you don't.
Hey, you know, Future, he trying to get his money. You know, he can't do what he can't do what Russ is doing right now,
man.
Fucking
with Russ.
Nah,
Russ is fucking his head up right now.
He isn't her business and all that.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
So he messed up right now.
When I list an artist that be in my playlist. So if I say, oh, yo, Future's in my playlist, right? Jeezy's in my playlist. Like, if I say that, that's all their best shit. You know what I'm saying? That ain't like no fucked up shit they can play recently.
If you're listening, Future, we want that Zanny family Future back. Please.
No, we want you to come on the show.
Fuck the music, come on the show.
Because I watched the Magic City documentary. Have y'all watched that?
No, I haven't.
You need to watch it. The Majesty
documentary.
I'm a very YouTube-ish person, because I happen to be clicking on some video. Yeah, it's made it city, over there, right.
Okay.
So, you know, that's how he ended up, you know, the song or whatever, that magic or whatever.
Keep going.
Yeah, I'm right. No. One of the, okay, magic. Well, okay, right. So, right. So that's how he came up with that song, because he be in Magic City or whatever. Like,
right.
You know what I'm saying? But that's a dope little documentary. I just watched it
the other day. I knew that about that song, but I didn't even know the documentary for that.
Yeah, I just watched it the other day. I was like, that's pretty fucking dope.
Man, it's completely different from this. Yeah, I'm more laid back. I'm on the J. Cole, Outkast, Scarface.
Classics. You can't go wrong with the Outkast.
I can all of them.
See, that's what I like. I listen to. I throw a little Wale in there from time to time.
Yeah, okay.
That's when you feeling like, you know, I'm feeling a little dolly right now. I need to, you know, my mental needs to be stimulated. You know what I mean?
He don't like lyricism, so that's
yeah, right. I love
it. And then, of course, when you slow it down, I thought, man, I really love her.
Ah,
let me tell you something right now.
What, I can't love her? I can't love her?
That Focus On Me, I love Focus On Me, and there's another one right now, and I was just playing it, and I think I said the name.
Say it again.
When I tell you say it again, is like, do you know say it again from her?
Not saying it for.
No, that's not me.
Google it. It's a dumb song.
What had happened was, is he.
My song is Avenue. That is my
jam.
Here you go. That's my jam. I like everybody's stuff. And what's fucked up is I didn't like her at first. She got on my nerves a little bit. And then she started growing on me because she kept coming up my damn playlist.
But
I was like, okay, let me give her a little shot. But now I'm in love with her.
But this is it though, real quick.
This
is the same.
Say it again.
Like when the beat hit the drop, like it's just gonna be
playlist
and
whatnot.
Who's
your celebrity crush? I'll be like, I ain't got one. Everybody has one.
Rihanna. That's easy for me.
She
spit
that out so quick.
Yeah, that's easy.
We
like Riri. I'm shooting all up in her club multiple times.
I'm getting up right.
You think I ain't? I'm
going to
try.
I'm going to have
he gonna be the baby
four of them things. Four of them things.
She out. Man, Pete, don't start this. Don't start this, Pete.
What? I need to be here. But I know.
Who's yours?
I can't say I really have one.
You're going to say somebody like Solange.
A woman's body should look like.
Yes.
I love her body. Like, it's not too fit, it's not too jiggly. It's like, oh my God.
And it's real.
Girl,
it's
I love
shit.
It. Like, keep it pushing.
Actually, he's preparing. That's why he's trying to get himself healthy, because she's gonna be in town tomorrow. So
he's trying to go to that.
Hey, he said he's throwing draws on stage and all of that.
I saw her performance in another city. I don't remember what city she was in, but it was a city she was in last night or last Friday. Y'all gonna love it. I hope
he buys like new draws and he just has them in his pocket.
Cause it's kind of
like,
he got him out the boyfriend kit.
I know you was not giving somebody my draws. I had my shoe and your new boyfriend starter kit. Like, that's why I don't even fuck with y'all. That's why I'm going back to, because she's gonna go through the back, Scott. So I'm going back to him.
Cause he know how to behave.
Right. Okay, so. Are you guys single in relationships, or what's that?
I'm single.
Single, ready to mingle?
I've been in a relationship for 13 years.
Okay, 13 years. That's some love right there. And that's a damn good thing. That's compromise. That's what I heard.
It is compromise.
That's what I heard. When I hear 13 years, I hear compromise.
It just takes communication. All you got to do is talk it out.
That's what I'm saying.
You have to be willing to communicate first.
Yes.
Well, this is my thing. If something bothers you, you have to be open enough to tell them that, and they have to be open enough to receive it.
Right.
Right? That, because people will hold shit in for a long, long time, and then it bottles up, and it becomes way more than it originally was, you know? So if they just would have told you what had started making them mad at the beginning, we would, you know, like, you have to tell, like, if you don't like if somebody does something to you, to tell that motherfucker, like, look, when you were doing that shit over, I didn't like that shit. Yeah. Don't do that shit no more. Right. You know what I'm saying? But in a nicer way, though.
Nah, after 13 years, you said
you say it just like that. But yeah. I'm saying at the beginning, you gotta reel them in at the beginning. After 13 years.
Right.
13 years, you can say it.
She checked me, I check her.
Yeah,
it'd
be like that.
No, you got to, though, after 13, no. After
but you
10,
also
got to,
once y'all check each other, you got to respect each other after.
That's why I said you have to be open enough to say it and receive it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you, that to me, that's a lasting relationship. Because nobody's perfect, right? And as long as you can find somebody and you can deal with their flaws, like, okay, these are your flaws, but your positives outweigh your flaws, you know? And I can deal with that, you know?
My problem with that is that you don't have to agree with what I'm saying, but just understand where I'm coming from. And then we can just have the conversation from there, because if you can't at least understand where I'm coming from, then we just gonna keep going back and forth without no understanding of nobody, and then we back at square one and we argue yet again about something that ain't got nothing to do with what we was originally arguing about.
Yeah.
So hold on, what about y'all ladies? What's going on with y'all?
I'm engaged.
Okay, well congratulations to you on your engagement. How long have y'all been engaged?
The date was last September.
Okay.
But he moved out of state for 3 months, so we canceled it for last year, and now we haven't reset a date because we got some things that we're working on financially before we cross the threshold.
Yeah.
We don't want to go into marriage in any sort of debt. Like, that's not what we want to do.
Okay. Yeah, basically all you're doing is throwing a party for everybody.
So. Exactly. So we want to, I don't want to have that stress, to be honest with you, so.
So what about you, Miss Lady over here?
Yeah.
So you know.
She said she wants that party.
I want to eventually marry somebody because I've never been married. But I believe the field.
Are we taking shots? Yeah.
She got the bags under the sink.
I see the bags under the sink. Okay.
Yeah. She said they go.
What does that mean? What's bags under the sink?
The boyfriend started kid.
No, I'm just playing, like, you know.
What would your song be on MySpace?
Right now on MySpace, my song would be, why you making so complicated? I'm Jay, we concentrated. Shout out though. Okay, so. I keep 100 real quick. Okay.
So since we know who's with and who's not with, what's y'all's favorite sexual position?
Oh, I'm from the back all day.
What up, C-Tess? So you from the back all day, all day.
Okay, that's
great. That don't matter to me. You gonna get there.
You gonna get there no matter what.
You and your chick don't have a favorite or go-to or like?
On the side, probably.
Morning, with the kids in the house.
Okay, yeah.
Gotta get it before everybody get
up. A couple of those that one.
Yeah.
That's already get it before everybody wake up and you gotta go to school and get up and get breath. That gets you like through the first 3 hours, 4 hours to work. Like I swear to
walk
in
the
work. Morning.
Morning.
Wonderful day.
That's
the bitch that came up to you when you first
You know you when that's when she got something.
Right, that bitch.
It's always the females that notice though. Don't let your homegirl come into work. Good morning. You like, bitch, you went good morning. What you done did?
Why was your morning so good, bitch? My high with gas in it, bitch. I was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck?
The fuck is you so jolly for?
I didn't get no dick, bitch. Why you so come to here all dick fired and shit. Like, and I'm sitting over angry and grubby.
High five
and
her.
I
kind of
like that GDG, that good dick glow. Yeah,
it's coming in good.
Got a little
morning.
Power to it. Yeah.
Y'all are so stupid. Okay, so. I actually have to get my charger out of my purse so my phone's ready down. I need the phone for our questions. Yeah. So, Mindy, will you explain the game and what we're about to play so I can get my charger?
Right on. So what we're going to do, we're going to play a little bit sports trivia. We are going to ask you guys a question, a piece or whatnot, and you guys have to guess the answer. And I believe how we're doing it is that whoever gets the most wrong by the game's end has to take a shot.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I better get them right. It's something that's it.
I got this hammer about this.
Are we letting them answer for each other? Like, if I ask you a question and he gets it wrong, can Pete, like, guess what the answer is for that question?
No, we're just asking them and whoever answers.
Okay, cool. So we'll just give the answer after that.
Turn his mic off. Turn his mic off. And I got this.
I'm close to the paper, so I can read it.
Now, don't be cheating.
Go ahead.
Don't be cheating, but now we're going to wait to the
final.
Okay.
Like, why can't I find the box? You know how you got the cord and then no box?
Okie dokie. What title is given to the NBA player who receives the Maurice Podoloff Trophy? What is that title called, Mr. Sports Guys?
Maurice Podoloff?
Yeah. So what title is given to the NBA player who receives this trophy? It's the Maurice Podoloff Trophy. What is that title he gets if he receives that trophy?
Oh, that's the MVP.
Alrighty then. That's very correct. It's the MVP.
Yeah, so, yeah.
Most valuable player.
She said that's very correct.
Yeah, I know what I'm doing.
We'll get to it.
Yeah, go ahead. Here you go, polo, drink, fish eye, drink.
Next question.
The answer ain't even on the paper.
Who
has the most NBA titles?
Boston Celtics.
Player.
Bill Russell.
Yeah, he had Russell.
Get to the bottom.
You got it wrong though. Who said Bill Russell? Oh, I'm sorry. My bad. Okay,
you got to take a shot. To have participated in both the World Series and the Super Bowl. Who
was
that?
Sanders.
All right now.
Take a shot.
A little shot.
That's it. Who has the most Super Bowl wins and how many do they have?
Pittsburgh Steelers with six.
But it's, you have right.
Tied with the Patriots with six.
Yeah, we got that right.
Get
another one.
You get it. Okay.
You got them both right. You said them both. I picked one where you had to pick two teams.
Yeah,
and he
that's
got
it,
that.
That's it.
Okay. In 1994, there was no baseball World Series. Why?
Because the forest fire in Oakland.
Earthquake and.
I knew it.
They weren't either.
94?
Yeah.
The
Freak Beat was in town.
Yeah,
the
Freak Beat
was in
Atlanta. Hey, wasn't
nothing like the Freak
Beat. They shut it down when the Freak Beat came.
I remember coming through Atlanta during the Freak Beat. I think we was coming back from Florida on a family vacation, and it was live on the interstate.
Yeah.
So I already know what the city was, and I was a kid. Yeah, I remember that. My mama said, "Turn, don't look at that, Dre." "Mama, do you see what she got?" That was a good trip.
Who has won the most baseball World Series?
New York Yankees.
Yeah.
You said no.
You said Yankees.
So did you?
No, I said New York.
New York who? Either way it goes, you're going to be wrong. So New York, cool.
Hold on, let me think. Can I say the Dodgers?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Cubs. Yeah. 1907, 1908, 2006.
They only won three?
They only won three.
My phone died, and that's the only part I received. But yeah, that's the right answer.
No, you got to look. Google that one, baby.
Well, Google it.
Yankees got 10.
Do they?
Yeah.
I thought they had 11, but you might be right.
11, yeah.
Okay, well, maybe.
Anyway,
Let me make sure I ask the right question to that answer. That's what I think I didn't do. I didn't write the, ask the right question.
Who had the longest drought ever?
Yeah, I think that's what it was.
Yes.
Yeah, my bad. Yes. That was the right question. Look, sorry.
Oh, look at this nigga here.
He got it right. High five. Okay.
Name the coach who has won both titles of the Rose Bowl and the Super Bowl.
Pete Carroll.
And.
Wow. Rose Bowl.
And
that
the Super Bowl.
That is a good guess, though.
I probably, yeah, because you played, I mean, you coached at USC.
But you got it wrong.
It was a good guess.
Let me think. What's your boy's name?
Because he almost got them all right.
You think I'm about to tell you?
What's the man's name coaching
Oregon? Bob Knight.
Come on, don't be no hater.
Mike P, what's the name?
Don't answer nothing for him.
I don't
care. Kind of, he's a grown man.
He gotta take a shot. Make him take a shot.
He's dead. He a grown man.
All right, let me see.
I'm giving him a shot.
I can look at him. I can look. I see it. I can't think of his name right now.
Dick Vermeil.
That wasn't it.
But that wasn't it.
That ain't it.
Yeah, got it wrong
in
a way.
It ain't it.
Okay. Well, you know, that was just a little bit of sports trivia right there. I just wanted to play with you guys. No, y'all did good, though. I'm telling you, a lot of people come on here and we ask them questions about what they do, and they get them like all wrong. So at least y'all got most of them right. So y'all did real good. Okay, so now we're about to get into our infamous game called Fishbowl Drunk Facts. Right, and what this is Pretty Girl Chronicles version of Truth or Dare. So,
yes, sir.
You have to get a question out of here, and if you don't want to answer it, then we got to do maybe take a shot. So.
I'm just getting you ready.
So both of you guys are going to answer the question, but how we're going to do it is, since you're on Mitten's IQ, when it's your turn to draw, you'll just give it to her, and then when it's Pete's turn to draw, he'll just give it to me, okay? But both of you guys got to answer the question.
Yes.
Okay, so Q go first to give it to Mitten.
You go first.
You go first. Well, Mitten always goes first because I read, you know, and tell everybody what he is, so it just, you know, works out like that. Go ahead.
Well, Redson.
Yeah, let's see.
Let us see your last 10 photos on your phone.
My last 10 photos?
Yeah.
What is it? Shut your mouth.
If you don't want to show the last 10 photos, then you can take a shot.
Nah.
There are options.
I should have went to Snapchat.
The last 10 photos, I got no problem.
But he went to the safe gallery. Mindy, go back out. And go back to the album.
Are you an album?
Yeah, look. Because
we needed the album.
All photos.
Negro.
There's all photos. That's my last 10.
Okay.
Nothing
got nothing but the memes and sports shit.
Get it. Yours out. Your turn. You both gotta do it. We told you.
All the deep pics are gone.
They deep in. They like 479
in.
That's what we gonna take somebody. We need to see your 500 pic. No, that's a deep pic right there.
But, make sure
might be.
All I photos. Keep saying we need to include
might
Google activity.
My kids, for real.
We need to see your Google activity for the past 2 weeks.
Google activity?
Yeah.
I ain't got Google account. I ain't got a Google account.
Nah, we want to see your Safari history,
huh?
Yeah.
He's in my phone, bro.
You can talk about, man.
Okay, so get one out and hand it to me.
Okay. It's getting easy. Get this.
What is the nastiest, freakiest thing you've ever done in bed?
Tongue slipped in the butt. I was great.
Tongue slipped in the butt.
On purpose, accidentally?
Accidental purpose. It's accidental purpose. Get it right, y'all.
Accidental purpose.
It is.
It is
what
it is.
Hey, shit happens, bro.
Hey.
Long way. You down there, you in the
room. Nobody said it best. As soon as he comes to his senses. So we going to forgive y'all.
Yeah.
Because at that point.
At that moment.
It was an accidental purpose.
I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know.
What is he? No, keep grabbing that. I'm going to keep going. But anyway, what? My turn?
No, only one of y'all answered.
I think they said the same thing.
Yeah, same thing.
Y'all said the same thing?
Yeah.
Okay, get another one out. Y'all can't be piggybacking off of this and answer me like what he said.
No,
that ain't going to work out.
Same time.
Same time.
Have you ever had a threesome?
I have. No. Choose wisely.
I'm trying to think. Well, I mean, when you consider a threesome?
Yeah.
Like, what do you mean? Like,
because, to be honest, me and that dude over there, we've been in the room with the same girl one time, so.
Yeah,
At the same damn time.
Yeah. But we weren't hitting at the same time.
It was like me, you, and another one in one, wasn't it?
Same day. Same girl.
Same girl.
Damn.
Shout out to the neighbor.
So, it didn't go down like.
So two chicks and you.
No, nah, it was one chick, me, the nigga who just happened to walk in here.
Y'all took turns.
Yeah, so it wasn't at the same time. It was taking turns pretty much, but we was all in the same room though.
That's a little hard. I hope somebody tell her that.
Do y'all see her now?
I like all photos. You already know what it is.
Like, they gonna go back. Whose photo was this? But yeah, shout out to her. Yeah, I don't know what she's doing with her life, but shout out to her.
Oh, so you do see her now? You be liking her photos?
Yes.
On social media? Yeah, I still see her on social media. Actually, last time I seen her physically face to face was first day of school. Her kid was the next classroom over for my son, so we spoke, said what's up, and just kept on moving.
We go way back. Yeah. My man just walked in PRP, we go way back, and we did a lot of silly,
your typical boy stuff.
What's some crazy shit y'all did? Like one just crazy story y'all did together.
Besides the threesome.
Not sexual. Just like some bad shit y'all did together.
Okay, so we used to do is garbage derby, where we would ride in cars with garbage cans out the window, pulling them down the street, letting them go. They hitting cars.
We
going in yards,
cars.
Hitting doors.
Y'all was some bad ass children.
And I mean, we would be flying down the street. Mm-hmm.
Shout out to
Chad. It was his idea. Yeah. Shout out to Kickapoo too. We was
six deep. So what we would do is, you know, the Herbie Curvy got the handles on the back, right?
Uh-huh.
So people at the only time, at that time, it was the only one who had a car until I got my car. But what we would do, we would stick our arm out the car, grab the garbage can, and people would take off. And we would gain momentum and speed. And once a parked car came, we would let it go and let that garbage can come 50, 60 miles an hour, boom, right into that car.
Mailbox, all stationary collisions. Fucking up people, making people's insurance premiums.
I know. They were paying $700 a month for car insurance because of your bad.
I would have beat the fuck out of you.
Remember that time we got stuck on that one time we was coming out of that cul-de-sac and we got stuck on that piece of wood and we couldn't get out? People was coming out. Oh man, it was crazy. Yeah, but luckily we never got caught doing it.
Luckily,
some people probably came back to the house that next morning pissed.
Oh, they was definitely
the whole street was ripped. We tore the whole block up. At that time, it was the funniest shit ever. At that time, it was.
They probably knew it was y'all. It was like old dude on Friday, the little boy,
the little boy,
or whatever. Yeah. That was y'all back in the day with these trash cans.
How long should sex last in your ass? Like from stroke count, not like foreplay and all that ooey gooey lovey dovey shit. From the moment you stick your dick in a pussy, how long should it last?
120 strokes.
120. Strokes. Look at
you count.
1, 2, 3. This bitch is 10
pounds. That's the only way he make it.
Hey, we get to 120.
That's the only way he make it. He got to count.
120. Hey, we just start wrapping this up.
Yeah, probably. 8 to 10 minutes. That's about it.
Well,
what's
8
to 10
minutes?
120 strokes.
That's what I said.
Down to the exact stroke.
I know. I'm going to give you 9 minutes and 47 seconds.
Well, right, now,
I know what's back.
So that 115 stroke, you already know what's coming. Yeah.
Already there. Yeah.
That's why I said he'd be on that all kind of cut.
And shout out to Larry Stark. Like he said, he hit it on the head. We only looking for that last 5 strokes.
That's
anyway.
It.
That's it.
The best moment in sex, that last 5 strokes.
That last 5.
For me, I would say probably cool 15 to 20.
Cool
15 to 20. Without no foreplay, just straight fucking 15 to 20. That gives you enough time to switch positions.
That boy's talented.
Hey, man.
He got some control.
Oh, well, right, I mean, you know, you gotta start thinking about like weird shit.
Other shit. You gotta slow down for a second.
Especially if that shit is dripping down the leg. Oh no, bro, this ain't gonna last. We need to talk about this.
And he said we need to
have a conversation.
Yeah, that's like what Cat Williams said. Real niggas get up out the pussy and start eating it for a little bit. Give yourself the calm down.
Right. If you start talking about shit, you slow down. You're like, it was good to see you today. I'm glad I came over here. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you try to start having a little conversation real quick, because then she ain't really thinking about you not fucking her at the moment, for real. All you gotta do is tell the motherfucker she beautiful. You know what I'm saying?
Forehead kiss, it's over.
Damn, you so
good. Yeah. Conversation, forehead kiss, tell her she beautiful. She gonna be in love with you by morning.
But I mean, if you're fucking her, you better think she's beautiful. Cause why are you fucking her if you don't?
We don't agree on that.
Well, to me, cause I don't fuck nobody I don't think look good. Like, I can imagine having sex with somebody I'm not attracted to. Like, I'm just gonna.
They like it. You know what I'm saying?
Everybody's pretty in their own way. That's how I look at it. I always
pretty to you.
He just found the loophole.
Everybody's pretty in their own light.
He just gave y'all the loophole.
Everybody look good in the right light. Hey,
everybody look good in their own way. Jesus says, what?
That's what I'm gathering from this conversation.
Everybody is beautiful. I agree with y'all. Niggas ain't shit.
Y'all
ain't shit.
He said it ain't gonna be shit.
Absolutely. Yeah, I went to college.
Oh.
Yes.
He said he didn't know their name. He said absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, at college,
another accident on purpose.
Are you protected?
Was I protected? Are you talking?
He said he was in college.
Back then, that Pete was a wild, wild boy.
He wasn't protected. He wasn't strapped.
And I know.
I don't want to tell you no, but not really.
But, hey, I was mad.
Pete was just a guy that just lived in the moment. He was just,
not the third person, though.
It wasn't you.
Nah, that's a different monster right there.
I shed him back in 2005. I shed him away.
He was
reborn into the Pete that you see now.
Once I hit 30, I'm DeAndre.
I
can't agree because I thought she peed on me, so I put her out.
Mm-mm. I love that shit.
You gotta go.
No, he said he done it.
Now I gotta get the floors and all that. Nah,
do it again. Do it again.
I had to
put a towel down. I'm cool out fat.
Do it again.
I had to watch the comforter set. I'm cool. Yeah, that's too much of a mess.
No, it ain't. That's a good mess.
The sheets is cool, but the comforter? Come on, man.
That's too hard to watch. Hey, you gotta go to the laundry man, use the big one. You know what I'm saying? To get that motherfucker cool.
$1.75 for the dryer, all that?
Man, it'll take a long time.
Just do it up cream. You ain't got to worry about that.
What? You said put plastic down, cover it up with aluminum foil. What did you say?
My dude said cover it up with aluminum foil.
I thought that's what you said. I didn't know what happened.
Yeah, they had to go. Gotta get out. Gotta go.
You put
her
out
after that? Gotta go. I said, did you pee on me? She said, nah. I said, but you still gotta go.
No, I like that. Keep it going. Let's keep it. I want to see how many times you can do it until you tell me to stop. But then grab another question.
Lord have mercy.
We're learning a lot today about, do you give oral sex?
Absolutely.
All day.
Nothing wrong with it.
All day.
I signs in at 9 a.m. and then I proceed to 12 a.m. all day with it.
I walk in and ask her, hey, you need me to eat that thing?
You know what I'm saying?
Has she ever said no?
Why would she?
Did you see my face? I was like, who is that?
Sometimes she'd be like, I'm too tired. I'm too tired.
She ain't got to do nothing but lay down.
What you got to do? You just lay there.
Yeah, what you say?
Like, I'm too tired. I'm sleepy.
My dick was hard when I walked in, but now my kids are right up. about all this shit. I'm gonna turn you up, sir. What?
They just remind us.
Pull out well before.
What's your favorite porn category? What's your go-to porn category?
Porn category.
Yeah. I rock with the heavy. You know, I only watch black porn. I don't watch any other porn.
He's racially motivated.
Look, you ain't gonna find it on here because when I go to my safari, I go to private. So you can't even pull it up.
I'm cool with that. But I like looking at Latinos and Mexicans. That's my answer.
Latinos and Mexicans.
Yeah, light skin.
I like looking at people that look like me and people I'm familiar with. You know what I'm saying? So if a motherfucker look too like not like my, me and my friends, I'm like, oh, I can't watch it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can only watch people that look like me and my people. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I can picture myself there, like, okay, that could be me and my people. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Then I can watch that. Right. You know what I'm saying? Right. That's the only way I can say it politically correct. You know, like, I wouldn't fit nobody because, hey, if you like it, I love it. But I'm just saying, I like to watch people that look like me and who I want to fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to look at who I want to fuck.
You definitely got to scroll to find that.
I didn't realize how much scrolling was involved in porn until I really started doing it, because you got to scroll for a minute. Because remember, it was fucked up for a minute while it was like an answering when it wasn't really supposed to be answering. So motherfucker could hear what you was doing over there and you didn't even know.
Damn.
Yeah, real quick, if you're watching this video, share this video, like the Pretty Girl Chronicle page, and like Beyond the Games page. Do you like to give your chick anal sex?
if she's into it, that ain't for everybody, but if she's into it, yeah, I'm gonna slide it on in there.
I'm gonna slide it on.
But like I said, a lot of women ain't into that, so you know, you can't be doing that with everybody.
No, I'll karate chop a motherfucker, so I'll break a nigga down so quick.
See what I'm saying? Yeah,
there.
So
no.
I can't just.
That's painful, no.
So you got to do tests. You got to see.
Yes.
What's the test?
You gotta stick your finger in there.
She's
like, okay,
she doesn't. But stuff my finger in a whole thing. Lots of chicks like the finger and still don't like
the second finger in there. She get that second finger in there.
Okay, you put two fingers, I'll punch you.
That's what I'm saying. Exactly. So it's time for the show.
Punch you. The second finger is a check. You be like, oh, she's through with it.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So she.
I'm gonna look at you differently. Like, see, we ain't even on the same level. So y'all talking to me. You got some old two finger shit. You know what I'm saying? I was with you with the one, and then you went two, and now y'all put you out. You know what I'm saying? I put you with the one.
Y'all put
you
with that left and right.
I got put you out with the two. Y'all gonna take your two with you. Okay. Another one. Now we just fucking around. You know, it's all jokes. It's comedy, people. It's comedy.
Yeah, it's all jokes till it's time to get to bed.
Right, and then I put a nigga out because he did a two. Now, you know, I was playing. I said I was playing, but I was serious about that part. I was serious.
Yes, I have.
Well, have you ever had your heart broken?
Hell yeah. Exactly. And I still be like, fuck her when I see her.
You know, that's because I didn't listen to mama. Mama told me.
That girl was the devil.
Nah, she said that high school relationship ain't gonna mean nothing. That's what she told me. Uh-huh. I ain't believe it.
What would your mama be trying to fight him and shit?
Hey, your mama be trying
to
fight him.
That's gonna be me with my son. That's how my mama be.
Baby, I hate you. I hate the types of mama.
I am. All of the bitch. You ain't
high school. Remember when your high school hit that PU there, when his ex hit that girl into that tree, and she was like, I don't even know because of this guy right here. His ex pulled up out of nowhere.
No, let's get the story right. Uh-oh. You called me. You said, I got some chicks over here I need to get rid of. Bring your bride over and tell her to beat them up.
That ain't the story.
So that's what we
but
did.
Look, why Q get quiet though. He's like, that ain't the story. I don't know. I'm thinking that was the story.
Is that the story? Look, he's over. He's telling.
I wanted her to lie that he was gonna come out of his
mouth.
You know her. Did she come over and beat him up though?
It wasn't open up. She just hit him one time. The chick fell all into my mama's tree, and she was like, "I don't even know you." And that was the end of the fight. That was
get
it.
Out.
Wow.
Hold on, but let me tell this story real quick because you know we don't hardly ever tell. Yeah, I don't know. But anyway, back in the day, I'm 18, Mindy's 18, 19. She called me. She said, "Hey, I think my dude's cheating. He over here at this apartment complex. We ready to roll up." You know, what you gotta do? You gotta put on your shoes, you gotta put your hair in a ponytail, take off all your jewelry, you know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta roll. So me and Mindy go over, guess what we head at? We go Shag Bar. So, you know how Shag Bar set up apartments at the top, apartments at the bottom. Mindy started at the corner of my fucking apartment. This bitch ain't playing. This bitch commits to knock on every motherfucking door. I'm sitting here like, Finally found where dude was supposed to have been at. Like, we had to go through eight motherfucking doors. Like,
oh, my nigga fucked up. You should have been listening outside. Like,
man.
Now we
have to say. And then she did, hold on. And then she did all that, and he was at a funeral. You see how bitches be tripping? Sometimes we be tripping.
But you say, Pete, black men don't cheat.
He wasn't cheating though. She was in that day.
But the fuck on her, let my baby daddy. That's the one that answered the door. See how you don't go with people to shit?
Actual.
You don't go with people to shit. My baby daddy.
Y'all knocking on doors and you ended up messing with your baby daddy.
Right. I didn't know him, my baby daddy. He answered the door. He was cute. He was like, yeah, nigga, be back. Come on in. I was like, shit, we coming on in.
And we came in and we smoked a bee and chilled with him until he got back.
Yeah. And then next thing I know,
I wanted to see if he came in with a chick. Nigga, we waiting. We heard.
Yeah, but anyway, because you and Huggin' Reggie, but here's the thing though, your baby daddy helped you. My, he didn't give a fuck about that nigga. He was trying to get his roommates, right? No, he was over chilling. No, this is random people shit. But he's not random people shit, like not in his house, somebody else's house. Somebody else's house. He was on somebody else's. Okay, funny. It's hilarious. If you could have sex anywhere in the world, where would that be?
On the table.
I would have to say
that nigga broke the table. I would have to say
the Bellagio out in Las Vegas overlooking the fountain.
I think that's a good one. I picture that whole thing right there.
Yeah, and it's actually, if you go to Vegas and you sit on the strip and look up in the window, it's a lot of people doing that.
Oh, I bet. I'd be like, fuck y'all, motherfuckers. I'd be up there riding, getting my motherfuckers a finger. You know what I'm saying? Like,
you probably catch one or two a night.
What about it? It's the best spot you can get.
Yeah, it is.
Project Winter.
You definitely have a crowd out there. What you talking about?
Hey, you want to be on the second floor, nigga? You
pulling up the white plastic chairs with popcorn and all that.
You hear me? You only 14 steps up. 14 steps.
Damn, I'm gonna take a shot.
Okay. Hey, you are comedy. You are really hilarious. He's comedy. Okay.
Get another one.
Wait, this is real. He's like, yo, no shot right there.
Have you ever been in a physical fight over a female?
Absolutely not. There's no reason.
It's over for everybody. You can have a family.
I don't even argue, you know.
She's yours, man.
Like I said, me and my girl, we've been together 13 years. We done been through some things. And like I tell A-Player, you can take her, you can have her.
You can have her. She wasn't mad. You can have her. I'm going to hit your sister. So we even. So nah, I I ain't never got a physical fight over no people.
Get another one out.
It comes to that,
you know, some people be just running up throwing blows. Yeah, you be like, damn, he just asked me for a light.
They
head over
heels.
Hey,
man, let me
get a shot. I made my birthday, Mike.
Get a shot. Right,
how old are you?
He look like he's about 31, 32. He's looking 38.
Hey.
That's his son.
Blessings.
Man, even though that motherfucker's gone,
they
make a nigga look
for all right. They bring character to you.
They bring character to you.
Bring character to you, man.
Oh, she's in the 40s right here. She's
hot,
ain't she?
Who's
in the
40s?
Yeah.
Who's in you right here?
Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Put your name on it. Your name, put your name on it. Your name, put your name on it. Put your name on it.
Yeah.
Oh, my bad. Has anyone ever paid you for sex?
Yeah. Fine pay.
Yeah.
Like $40 on the dresser.
Nah, I got some Jordans. Yeah,
I not Jordans.
He's like, I got items.
I mean, I get.
I got phone shit.
I got a salad.
He said a salad. What's the good Zaxby's? Because they got some really good salads.
So, hey, Zaxby's
salads is droll. I fuck with you. I already went.
What if you want to buy a salad? So if you mean cash,
nah, I never got cash.
Like material things, yeah, like some J's.
And you start like taking your tongue and going like, damn, I'm really fucking up my shit. Like you start.
I think that's how your mouth bleeding and shit.
As you start feeling like I can eat a little bit more, like it ain't that bad. You know what I'm saying? Like you start.
Have you ever cheated on someone?
Absolutely. Every day.
Every day. I like my walk around cheating.
No, I'm just like,
wake up.
I'm just
cheating,
like, oh, yes,
sleep,
it has happened.
This thing's
happened.
He said it has happened.
This nigga said every day.
It's known to happen from time to time.
He said every day. Hey, I only cheat on two occasions. That's day and night. That's the only time I cheat. Two occasions. And it's day and night.
I mean, you know. Because social media now, they call, you know, when you messaging
and you cheating.
That is cheating.
So you really are cheating every day.
You are really cheating. You are
don't do that.
Serial cheating.
Don't do that.
That is cheating.
Don't do that. I don't have to delete messages out of my phone. The only reason I got a lock on her because it's an 8.
That's like somebody saying my phone was dead all day. That's why I didn't answer my phone. You bet.
That makes you put a lock on her.
You know what? I'm through with y'all on these.
But you know, with these new social medias,
with
these new social medias, everybody's too accessible. I mean, you know, like you
get on. Just because it's accessible don't mean it's for you. Don't mean it's
but
I'm, for
but,
you.
But I'm saying though, it's like somebody just sends you a message. You might just read it, not even reply back, but yet you gotta delete it because your bride might get your phone and be like, "What she say? I know you said something back, and you probably."
Okay, first off, when you're gonna be in a relationship, it has to be trust. If you break that trust and she does that, that's your fault. You should have never broke that trust.
I think if you ain't go looking for dirt, you ain't gonna find
it. It should be nothing to find, bro.
I don't know. I think it looks more suspicious when I go into your messages and there ain't one message in there. Like, not even the one I sent you. Like, damn, you deleted my shit too. Like, this nigga did a quick select.
Okay, no evidence at all.
I must have been coming in the door.
No evidence at all.
I hate that with passion. First off, there shouldn't be anything to find. Like, you shouldn't have a heart attack if I have your phone. We could swap. Me and my dude can swap phones all day, and neither one of us have an issue.
See, the thing is, I can do that because I got a passcode.
So she can't get into it. It disabled the phone. She tried 10 times.
She was struggling?
Right.
No, that's creating the
trust.
I can't
make a
call on your phone for
30
minutes. Well, leave it alone.
You know what I do? I keep doing it disabling your shit. You ain't going to be on back on this motherfucker tonight. Which I'm going to do. I'm going to be mad. I'm going to keep doing it.
Reset it.
And as soon as you reset it, go to the bathroom. All night. All right. I'm gonna teach you about that motherfucker. Lock that bitch if you want now.
I'm gonna tell you. Girl, out your phone, man. You get Candy Crush.
Nah, but you know, Candy Crush.
Yeah, that's what I'm playing.
Look, why is Pizza Hut calling at 3:45? They ain't even open. Okay. Pizza Hut is not 24 hours. Get enough with them.
We only got initials in this phone.
Initials. I hope you're watching and I hope you're taking notes.
She knows.
I'm in the show.
She knows. She'd be like, who was Kim W? I'd be like, come up with a woman's name with a Q.
She ain't Quanisha.
Quanisha
Waller. Hold on, we can go all day because I know some Qs right here.
Yeah, me too.
Honey, I was in school with like 13 of them. We can list them right now.
Not that hard.
And if it wasn't their first name, it was their second name. Let's go. Man, okay.
And if she want to know, just call the number. Fuck asking you. Me, I know. Just call it.
Like, and I'm going to be like, I need a large pepperoni extra cheese. And I'm going to give them the address. Yeah, we over here at 1747. No, I'm
just
playing.
Okay. So,
Pizza Hut already know what we're doing. Right. You know, we already on the way. You hear me? We already on the way. Okay.
Being true.
Okay. You know, like their address pops up, GPS has already been activated. Oh, we coming. Okay, have you ever thought about an ex while you was with your current partner?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody said hell yeah.
It happens from time to time.
Yeah.
That's why I said it's social media. It's
for somebody to cross your mind.
I ain't even got a partner, but I'm still thinking about this bitch.
No, we mean like, why y'all having sex though?
Yeah,
like
you're
having sex.
And then somebody
else
popping
your
head.
Not like
that.
Yeah,
that's what we mean. Yeah, it's normal. Yeah, but we mean like, if you bone in, there's another chick crossed your man.
Nah, I don't.
You just cheat all day, every day.
Nah, he's just trying to get some stroke 115.
And that's it. And then I know it's on after that.
This chick is not satisfied. Whoever this chick is with these little numbers. Okay, get one more out, then we're gonna end it. That's not my problem, instead.
Damn, that was hard up.
Just throw me out of my butt.
If you could fuck anybody in the world, who would it be?
What's up, my man?
That goes back to earlier. Rihanna.
Rihanna?
Yeah.
Riri, he's trying to bone you.
Anybody.
Me.
You want to fuck anybody in the world, who would that be? You could get them right now.
What?
Like you better take a shot, man.
I'm trying to get a group.
You know, like you gotta take a shot, my dude.
It is, because I mean, you know, social media, I can shoot my shot at everybody. I done been shot down a lot.
Boy, I tell you what.
Yeah, I don't know.
Here you go.
Take a shot. Okay, well, while he's taking his shot, Quentin, why don't you tell them where they can check out your podcast or your show?
You can find us on WLXU 93.9 FM. If you can't get it down here, you can also download the WLXU app. Tune in on Monday nights from 6 to 7. If you happen to miss the show, you can always follow us and catch the podcast on iTunes, SoundCloud, and go back and listen to previous shows. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Beyond the Game KY.
You
want
to say your personal or anything? Any shout outs? Because he kind of said it over there. Just want to give you a little moment. You good about it? Okay. Maybe where can they find you? A little sexy ass there.
You guys can find me on Facebook as Mitty Jones, IG as Miss Mitty Jones, and Snap as Pretty Body Jones.
Okay, and you can find me, Coley Rodriguez, on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat. It's all the same. Keep it pretty simple for you guys. You can like the Pretty Girl Chronicles page. You can come out to Val Thursdays right now. It's about to get cracking. 2928 West Kentucky Street at Cozy Vent Center. Sold out Saturdays is back this weekend. So make sure you check out Sold Out Saturdays. Don't think about it. Don't be like, are they open or they not? They open. So just come on out. Okay, and you are watching Pretty Girl Chronicles, and we're at Cold Place, and we are with Beyond the Game, P and Q.
Don't you open up that window. Don't you let